Greetings everybody, Okanya Games Online. Welcome back to more Sunset Overdrive. Last time, we became the hero of comics, apparently. And we finally got a new weapon, the Roman Candle. A machine gun-ish weapon. But we'll probably see more use of it in this episode. And we also saw that Two-Head Jack has another weapon in stock that we didn't have enough money for. Or rather, enough overcharge. I guess that counts as money in this world. We live in a crazy enough world as is. What with our currency and whatnot and all that jazz. And I'm not going to get into talks about currency. We have to get some comics. And once we get all the comics and complete this mission, we will... Well, we're going to have the ability to buy another weapon. Which is probably going to replace my... this one, Captain Ahab. Because Captain Ahab, it's nice, but it's at level 5. I don't really have much more use for it right now. Well, I might use it again if I level up all my other guns to level 5. But, let's get to searching for the comics. Because there's one in this area, which is... who knows where. So up here. And I've come to the top of this, and nothing. What the balls? Is it somewhere? It's gotta be somewhere. Yeah, dumb question, huh? Is it here? Is it here? It has to be down here somewhere. I am really not liking finding these comics, by the way. In case it wasn't obvious. Okay. Parking spot. This place looks like it would be a likely place to hide a comic book. And there's that one! Awesome! So, where is the comic book? I am very, very confused. What? You know what? We've had weird things happen. I shouldn't be... There's the comic book! Just dropped out of the sky.
So I've been thinking about your superpowers. You obviously have the power to grind on, like, anything. Maybe you should be the grinder.
I think you should stick with Comic Knight.
Yeah, cool. Okay.
Yeah, I'm gonna back you up on this one, player. The grinder. I'm gonna let that one sit on its own. It shouldn't take too long for people to put two and two together. And as bad as I am at 2-2.
It's more luscious mint pages from the grips of Gross City villains. No, Gross City is such a terrible name. I need a good name for what Sunset City has become. Something, I don't know, like darker, like Twilight City. Oh man, that's good. Yeah, and it appeals to girls too. Your comic is going to be such a hit.
Yeah, they just went there. Shots fired at Twilight fans. I'm not sure if I really say it's shots fired in this case, but I don't know. I never made sense to begin with, and we have all learned this lesson. Why can't I get the comic?
I was thinking about your backstory.
There.
Now, is it a little far-fetched if your parents died and you were raised by reading comics?
We seem more far-fetched. Let's be real here. Alright, there's... coming up on a few more comics. The area... God! Okay. There's another comic right around these areas. Two comics. Where the balls they are is a question for me to find out. Not up here. Is this getting near a case where the comic just ends up falling from the sky randomly? I hope not. Let's start by looking around here. Oh. Maybe you're here? Oh, I think I see him. Looks like this guy's got our comic that we need. And he's... Alright, we're gonna have to use a little bit more heavy arsenal. Namely, let's go with Acid Sprinkler. And that's not where I wanted to put that acid sprinkler. Okay. Cool game. Didn't want to work for me today. Let's try a room. Actually, this isn't super... Oh, God. Oh, God. Getting out of here. Another bit of the hit does... Eh. TNT does some damage, but TNT also has low ammo. The dude is gonna be the dude.
What if you carry Superman's magic harmonic, and that's where you get your power? Oh, and then gold and book lice would be your weakness. So cool.
Yeah. Sure, we'll go with that. I can't really speak from experience for any of this, because as I also said in the last episode, I don't read comics at all. The closest thing I've read to a comic that I enjoy, which is technically a graphic novel, is the Scott Pilgrim vs. the World. And that's because of all the video game references in the novel. But, so I guess as hard as I might be on him for his comic book edition, it's pretty much the same for me in video games, so I can't talk. Yay! That's not kind, but I'll take that. Excuse me for a second as I blow up all this stuff.
Okay, so at this point, he's got this magic comic and a mission to save the comics of Twilight City. The story needs more.
How about a villain?
Yes, a villain. Someone who hates comics. Like my ex. Just kidding. Not really. I actually never had a girlfriend. Whatever. Anyway, I gotta think about this. Just keep up that first edition Justice comic night.
Alright. What happened to the girl? Never mind. It's probably him talking to his plushies, like all nerds do. Okay, now. I really gotta stop bashing on nerds, because, well... Is it really me bashing on nerds? Because when I'm bashing on nerds, am I kind of bashing... You know what? Remember what I said a few seconds ago about me never making sense and be done with it. There we go. Problem solved. And, wait, this area looks kind of familiar. I feel like we've already been here once to get a comic. Haven't we? Oh. Well, maybe we did and I missed this, or I appear later. Thanks, game.
Figured out your nemesis. Musty Mildew. I mean, what do comics fear most, right? Maybe you used to be lovers or whatever, but then she had like a freak drowning accident, and now she's only being kept alive by a symbiotic mold. An evil mold. And the mold is in her head, making her totally crazy. I can see the movie already.
Yeah, I can too, if only we had the necessary tools or such. Alright, there's the next comic.
You know, Musty Mildew is a perfect nemesis. I mean, think about what would happen if her musty mildewness ever got near your magic comic. Who knows if kitty litter and baking soda could even bring the magic back.
Alright, give me some ammo. Could use ammo. Looks like it was mostly ammo for the dude, which, I'll take it. I'll go bowling any day of the week. I actually really enjoy bowling, personally. I used to bowl a decent amount. I don't really bowl anymore, but back when I did, I really enjoyed bowling. But hey, personal stories we're not here for. Well, maybe. Maybe some people like them.
I just had an amazing thought. If your magic comic ever gets musty, you can always collect more comics to restore your power. Then we could have a whole series of comeback issues building up to a climactic fight. This could easily be 100 plus issues.
Alright. Two more comics to get, and we have to go a little bit of a distance to get to both of them. Namely, that other one. But this is where the ability to grind around comes into play. And this is also where that happens. Go a different way than you want to. Alright, here's the location of the next comic. Looks like a good place to put down the acid sprinkler. Yeah, OD killing badge. No shit game. Whoa. I hate those poppers. And there's another comic.
Okay, this is going to get full circle. Comic Knight, I mean you, could be rocked by all this guilt because you could have saved Musty when she needed you most, but you were too busy reading comics the day she drowned.
Is this art imitating life here?
Any connections here are purely coincidental. This is a monumental tragedy. I mean, she blames the comics. And maybe you secretly blame,
myself?
Oh, no way. No. What? No. How could you have known she was suffering all that time? Come on, get back on board with this.
Alright. Sure, we'll keep getting on board. Regardless, one more comic. And then we're done with this mission. And it's you.
Fight with Musty Mildew. Maybe there's still some consciousness left in her brain. You're still in love with her, so you don't want to kill her. You just need to get rid of all that mold so she can rest in peace. None of the conventional ways work. That's for sure.
Well, let's head on back. And we'll see if you can put together the rest of that idea. Ah, here we go. Walk very slow. It feels so weird walking in this game now.
Thanks. So, now, you ready for this ending?
Definitely not.
So in order to defeat Musty Mildew, the Comic Knight has to sacrifice the very thing he loves most.
The Super Mint Magic Comic.
Yeah. How did you know? I guess you are the Comic Knight.
Yeah, and I'm not doing it. I've got comics to save. No way I'm giving up my powers for moldy old love.
Wow, you're such an anti-hero. There's so much truth in this art. I'm done collecting. I've got to get to writing all this down. And you, good luck out there, Comic Knight. One man in this town believes in you.
Yay, one man. Oh well, got him all the comics, the ultimate collection. But the nice thing about that, because of all that overcharge burning a hole in our pocket, how do we carry this much overcharge on us? Is there like a bank account for overcharge? Like, how? Don't ask. Video game logic. Move on. You'd think I would know this by now. I've done Let's Playing for a year and a half now at this point. You'd think I'd know video game logic. Apparently someone doesn't learn their lessons, and that someone is me. But hey, someday I will learn my lesson. Someday. Alright, let's see if we can find a two-hat jack shot. Well, asking you shall receive. There's one on my mini-map right now. Let's head on over and get ourselves a new weapon. Weapons. Turret copter.
My guns are like my children. I build them, I love them.
Alright. We have a new weapon. Gonna replace our Captain Ahab for now. Turret copter. Fires out a projectile that pops open into a floating turret. Low damage, high range, long lifetime. Okay. What do we got? 6 ammo. Great. Let's test this. Okay, so it is what it sounds like. It's a turret. And it shoots anything that comes near you. Okay, that's pretty respectable. It doesn't fire fast, which is my complaint with it, but other than that, I like it. It's always enjoyable having some sort of turret weapon in a video game, but the next thing we want to do, besides kill all these OD and get a ton of experience from it, seriously, all these OD. Alright, that should be good enough for now. We have new challenges that I started looking through. First off, we've got a new bomb delivery. So we're going to open up with that, for these challenges anyways. If you're looking for the sprint button, it's called grinding. Thanks, game. Alright. 1, 2, 3, 4. Here we go. Time to deliver some very dangerous packages. Scavs are hauled up all over Little Tokyo. Flush them out by delivering some time bomb surprises. Make it snappy. Don't want these things blowing up in your face. Will do, game. Let's get to business. And this probably won't go well the first time, but who knows? All of the wires will kill you. Good word of advice. There's another. That one is also pretty. As someone who enjoys playing Keep Talking and Nobody Explodes, the blue wire, the red wire, I really like that quote.
It's dangerous to go alone. There's another. Totally not explodey thing.
Okay, that's also high up on there. That's a pretty good reference.
This one's for you.
God, the jokes get better and better. Now, if only I could say my score would get better and better. Yeah, I see a few spots where I could improve my time. So, let's work on that. Get this first.
Dysentery. I mean bombing.
Let's go over this way next. And I walk very slowly.
You really pissed at me in a few seconds.
Yeah, I don't see us doing it this attempt. I mean, who knows? Maybe we will. And maybe it will be glorious. Special delivery. Okay, go. No! Don't jump. I feel like we did about the same as last time. Let's find out. No, we got it. Cool. Okay. Now, move on to the next challenge down the list. Smash TVs. Again, appreciate the reference. Destroy as many TVs as possible within the time limit. Bonus points for any time remaining. Yeah, Smash TV is a really good game. But it's difficult and it's a quarter sucker game. Alright, let's get to business. There's a lot of TVs in the area. Can we use our weapon? Because I'm gonna. Oh, melee only. Thanks.
Way better than movies these days.
Nah, dude. Well, I guess, but I was gonna say, like, YouTube's better overall. And, like, you can just find whatever you want on YouTube. But, again, that's just me. I mean, ignoring the fact I'm also a Let's Player. Which might also influence my opinion a bit. I mean, that aside. Oh god! Okay. I don't see any more TVs. They're probably higher up. Yeah, they are. Shit. Damn it! Alright. Well, how is our score? Probably not the best. Yeah. Let's try it again. Start with that. And that. And then these. Alright, good. Good. Get those ones. Get those. And those, and there's TVs there. What is this, Persona 4? Well, I had a counter with some sort of reference. I mean, we had the Smash TV reference. Alright, I think that was slightly better. Game says otherwise. accept, and this will also probably be the last challenge for the episode where we finally finish this challenge. These, get these. Get these.
Kill your TVs.
Go here. And here. And there. And let's get the TVs that are high up here. Come on. Okay. Decent. I could have gotten those if I was a little faster. At least I'm getting money for this, but, challenge. Surprisingly difficult. No. Stop it. Go here, go there, go up here, destroy that, destroy that,
this is too bad.
Destroy that,
is way better than movies these days.
Go, come on, come on, come on, we're pretty close, we've gotten very, very close before, okay. There's the time again. Did we actually get it this time? Motherfucker! What the shit?
This is some profound statement about media and our culture, isn't it? Or maybe it's just fun to smash TVs!
This is a nightmare! Okay, maybe we should switch up the order a bit. Let's go for these TVs. Oh my god, stop jumping around like a pony and smash the frickin' TVs. We're here to smash TVs, we're not here to have fun. Ah, who the hell am I kidding? We're here to have fun here. Smashing TVs is always a fun time. And, well, it's not a fun time if you move slow as balls. Okay, let's get these. Let's get the ones up here. Alright, well. Ah, my god. I'm gonna be here for a while. Cut away. Of course, when I say I'm gonna cut away, I get no problem. The cycle is never ending. Thanks, game. Appreciate that one. Oh well. We got some more challenges done. We got a new weapon, the turret copter. And we have a few more challenges on the agenda. What else do we have? Actually, is that all the challenges that we had on the agenda? Yeah, it is. We have another smartphone text by the looks of it. But let me just double check. Is that all the challenges we have right now? I mean, we had the Buck National ones, but we're going to be doing those later. Traversal Challenge, which, you know what? Traversal challenges usually take no time at all, so we'll fit this last one in because we can. We're going to be having a slightly longer episode than we usually do, but, hey, it'll be fun. I personally really like the traversal challenges. I do want to see more points challenges, though. What's this? Let's get to it. The skating. Go here, go here, go up here, and done. Yeah, no problem. Alright, now we are probably done with this episode. Alright, we did a bunch of challenges in this episode. We have fulfilled our role as the hero of comic books, the comic knight, if you will. We got a new weapon in this episode. We made a lot of progress, like, in general. Not specifically story, though, but that will be next episode. Next time on Sunset Overdrive, we're gonna be making some story progress, as we have gotten through pretty much every main quest that is available to, or like every subquest anyways, that's available to us now. But before we do that, I will probably pay a visit to Floyd to see if we have any new amps available. I'll do that in between recordings, and if we have new amps available to us that we can buy, I'll show me buying them and equipping them to weapons, and then we'll head on over to where we need to go. Otherwise, I'll just see where we need to go. See you guys then!